Better to let the dead rest in peace.
Stay away from me! If you try to get in, I'll shoot!
I see nothing remarkable. Two little sailor boys. This just won't do. Too late. I'm sorry, Lombard. You may have left those men to die, but Owen had no right to be your executioner.
Chapter 10. One little sailor boy left all alone. He went and hanged himself, and then there were none.
I hear a voice. No, voices. They're coming from upstairs.
How could you get into my room so easily?
I've always had a duplicate set of keys, Miss Claythorne, as a former and actually the current owner of this house.
You own this house?
I have for several years. I saw to it that Emily Brent died 2 weeks ago. I took her place for the weekend. My finest performance, I think. Worthy of the Oscar the Academy always refused me.
But the bee stings!
Hurt like hell, and did nothing for my complexion. But Emily Brent was allergic, not me. It's my apiary, after all.
Who are you?
My name is Gabrielle Steele. You've seen my posters in the screening room.
The actress? Some scandal in Hollywood.
Scandal? Well, I guess if you call trying to kill your leading man a scandal. Yes, it was. My final picture, Last of the Borgias. Something happened. Lillian Borgia, the character I portrayed. One day on the set, suddenly she was inside my head. She wormed her way in. That's the only way I can think to explain it. Telling me to do things. Showing me how. They called it a breakdown. I now like to think of it as a meeting of two minds.
But why this elaborate plot? Why kill all these people? Why?
Wargrave, of course. He was absolutely right. He was the central character in our little drama.
The Edward Seton trial?
Yes. Edward Seton. My love. My life. We met some years ago when I first came to London to star in a play in the West End. Then, after the incident in Hollywood, I came back to England to rest. They wanted me to rest. Edward and I fell in love. I cannot describe to you the depth of our love. You wouldn't understand. I've seen how you flirted with Lombard and Narracott, playing them off against one another.
Did I? I was frightened and confused.
I suppose that's as good an explanation as any. I was never confused. Edward was an innocent man, railroaded by that venomous old judge, simply to prove a point. That it was his courtroom, his law. 3 days Edward suffered. He couldn't bear the shame or what it would do to me. He killed himself for me. I wanted Wargrave to suffer those 3 days, watching as death approached, powerless to prevent it.
But why the rest of us?
I met Miss Brent at a resort soon after I arrived in England. Hateful old hag. I think I caught her qualities quite nicely. I heard how she had punished Beatrice Taylor for her so-called sin. Drove her to take her own life, just as Wargrave had driven Edward to suicide. I wanted to extend Wargrave's torture for 3 excruciating days. What better way than to make him watch others die? Crimes committed under his very nose. Deaths he was helpless to prevent. How his ego must have been scraped raw.
You researched? Found us all?
Others who had apparently escaped justice, like Miss Brent. With the help of my attorney, Archibald Morris.
How could he agree to help with such a mad plan?
Mad? Madmen kill for no reason, no sense of justice at all. I only killed those who deserved to die. And Morris was a perfect little lawyer, asking no questions as long as the money was good. He'd been responsible for a few miscarriages of justice on his own, so killing him was not a serious moral dilemma. Then the stage was set. We arrived on my island, and the play began. The trickiest part was goading Armstrong into getting so drunk he wouldn't notice the imperceptible pulse that remained after I took the curare. A few bee stings and then a liberal application of Bellman's universal embrocation to complete the effect. It causes a nasty rash. He saw what he expected to see, a severe allergic reaction that can only result in death.
You killed the judge twice.
Hardly. The first time was some fool scheme he cooked up on his own with Armstrong, so he could pretend to be dead and catch Mr. Owen. I admit stealing Miss Brent's grey yarn and fashioning a wig from it was a nice touch. So angry. I couldn't think who had done it or why. I thought braining him with his own law book would be enough to fit the Chancery run.
If you shoot me, you'll be arrested. Patrick will catch you.
I'll deal with Mr. Narracott presently. Then I'll take poison. This ring I wear is a prop from the Borgia movie. Came in very handy this weekend. First for Marston, then Ethel, then my own Karari. And now, here we are. Once I'm dead, you can hang yourself and complete the rhyme.
And if I refuse to hang myself?
My dear, what do you think will happen to you if you're the only person found alive on an island with 10 dead bodies? If you don't hang yourself, the law most certainly will.
Patrick!
You killed her, Narracott.
The tickets are all booked. Suitcases are in the boot of the taxi. We're all set.
Thanks, Pat.
Don't thank me. If I'd been able to save at least one person on Shipwreck Island, they could have corroborated Bloor's confession. You'd be cleared and we wouldn't be running to Australia.
Are you sure you have to go?
Fred, there are 10 bodies on that island waiting to be discovered. Mr. Owen was right. The law would see that the last little sailor boy hangs.